I'm connecting the repository now. Deepu, will you operate?
Sorry, I couldn't hear that.
Nothing, nothing. Just I'm thinking giving you the keyboard and mouse permission, but remotely it makes difficult. I'll operate.
Yeah, it'll be so slow, right?
So now, here I have a folder, repository folder, that is Nala Jala, right? Otherwise Nitish. I have a repository folder, Nitish, right?
Okay.
I'm making this folder active folder. Okay. Now you see, I'm going for source analyzer. I'm looking about importing source definitions, right?
Yeah.
So what are the sources now? Means, just let us see. What are the, there are multiple sources here.
Okay.
Here you see the username JSRDB is the username. At present I am using username JSRDB, right?
Okay.
In this username I have tables.
Excuse me, sir. Select lo miru W ichar, sir, by typographical mistake.
These are the tables available, right?
Okay.
So here I have table EMPTBL1. I have a table that is EMPTBL1. This is the data available in EMPTBL1, okay? This is one employee table. In this table, I have employee data, right? This is another EMP table. This is the data available in the another EMP table. Totally, I have two EMP tables, right? These both are my sources. Of course, here I keep both the tables in same database. But let's assume that, let you think about EMP table 1 is in one database, EMP table 2 is in another database, okay? At present, both are in the same database, but you think that just like both are in different databases. You understand? All of you. Deepu.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Nitish, Sunan.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, there are two different EMP tables. EMP table 1 is having some employee records. EMP 2 is having some employee records, right? Moreover, you see, Here under Sushma folder, I have tables EMP 30 data, EMP 20 data files, right? This is a different variety of source. Here, some more employee records are there, right? In this file, I have some more employee records. EMP 20 data. Here, there are some more employee records, right?
Yeah.
Totally two tables and these two flat files are my sources.
Okay.
Yeah. Now I need to import source definition. Import from database. JSRDB is the username. Then JSRDB is the password. Click on connect. Here I do select both the tables, right? Okay. Now both the sources are imported. Both the sources are imported, right? So now I need two more sources. Go to the source, import from file. C drive. Sushma is the folder name. Data. Okay. This is a source. This is delimited flat file. The delimiter double quotes is the quotes. Click on next. Here you enter the column name EMPN. Data type is numeric of 4. Okay.
So నేను చేయను సార్ ఇక్కడ నుంచి కెన్ ఐ డూ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్
హియర్ నార్మల్ చాలా స్లోగా ఉంది అండి
ఓకే
సో హియర్ 10 ఇస్ ద లెంత్ ఫర్ ఈ నేమ్ నెక్స్ట్ జాబ్ Text again. Next column name MGR. Next column name hire date. Type is date time. Next one is sal. Numeric 7,2. Next one is commission. Numeric 7,2. Scale 2. Next one is DEPTNO. Right? Yeah. Click on finish. Okay. Just I am taking three sources only. Fourth one I am not taking. Just I am taking three sources. Just observe the three sources carefully. See, three different sources metadata is the same. Structure of the three different sources is absolutely same, right? Understand?
Yeah.
But data is different. In first source, you have different set of records. In second source, you have different set of records. In third source, you have different set of records, right? Here, what I want to do is, I want to merge all the records and load into single target. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
I want to merge all the and I want to load the data into single target. Got it? So I want to create a target here. Here simply under Oracle, I have EMP table 1 that I am copying and I am renaming it as EMP all L. This is Oracle. Here you see columns. Of course, for the comfortability, I am making it 15. Everything is fine. But here I am taking one more column. That is EMP dim key, right? Operation and scale. Okay, length is 10. This is primary key. Yeah. The target table structure. Are we clear about target table structure?
Yeah.
Only extra one column I have taken. This is target. So I want to extract data from three different sources. Merge data together and load into single target. This is what I want to do here, right? So what can I do now? So here merge transformation. How to merge? The union transformation in Informatica used to merge the records. Okay? I believe all of you know about set operators. Union, union all, intersect, minus. These kind of set operators in SQL. In Informatica, we have a transformation that is union. The union transformation behave like union all operator in SQL. The union transformation, like union all operator in SQL, okay? So as per this example, not only merging the data, I have to generate the dimension key, right?
Yeah. Sequence generator.
But we will use sequence generator. Understand?
Okay.
Three different sources. Union transformation. Generator.
On a target.
On the target, right?
Yeah.
Just give me a minute, I'll be back. Yeah. So I believe all of you understand what example we are going to do today, right? Hello, all of you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
So now I want to make sure my target is created. So here, so I have another database, RiniDB. So I'm creating my target here, right? So select the target definition, go to targets, click on generator, execute SQL, connect, RiniDB. Creating the table, generator execute. Yes, table is created, right? Let's start from tab EMP all TBL, the table created, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the structure of the target table. So sources are readily available, target is readily available, go to the mapping, go to the mappings menu, click on create, enter name of the mapping, map underscore union underscore sequgen, sequence generator, union and a sequence generator, okay?
Okay.
Here, the is ready. Take the source one, EMPTBL1. This is source one. Okay. The sources can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. It doesn't mind. See, here second one I am taking EMP30 data, right?
Yeah.
This is the second source I am taking. Third source, I am taking EMP table 2. Got it?
Okay. So one thing, sir, if like we should have the we in the law for all the fields, the data type and length should match. Is it right?
Yeah. Here, when you are using union transformation to match the data, the columns and the data types, data lengths, metadata must be the same.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Structure of the sources must be the same. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Even though column names are different, somewhere ENO might be there, somewhere else EMPNO might be there. Okay. Somewhere else EMPNUM might be there, but data type and data length must be this suitable, compatible, must be the same, right?
Okay.
See, here all these sources, three different sources, are having the same data type and data length for the columns, right? Observe carefully. Where is the same? Here 10 is there, of course.
Not same, sir.
Here 9 is there, here 10 is there.
10.
9 fits with 10, right?
Yeah.
Like that.
Okay.
Compatible, simply similar. Okay, metadata is the same. Now you create union transformation, go to transformation menu, click on create. Create union transformation. Where is the union transformation? Here is the union transformation. Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Select union transformation. Match EMP data. This is the name of the union transformation I gave, right? Click on create, click on done. See, observe the union transformation carefully. Whenever I created union transformation, by default it is having groups, right?
Mm.
I think you people understood about these groups in rotor transformation. Okay. So rotor transformation have multiple single input group and multiple output groups. For the output groups, you do specify your own criteria. Got it? We do specify multiple conditions in the rotor transformation. But union transformation is not like that. Just you see, this is 1, 2, source 3, 3 sources, right? And you are taking an union transformation here. In union transformation, you will have one output group, multiple input groups, right? So this is input group, this is group, this is an input group. So here source 1 is connected with input group 1, source 2 is connected with input group 2, source 3 is connected with input group 3. The union transformation merge them and gives you output. Got it? All of it clear? So union transformation contains one output group.
Multiple input groups.
Input groups. Got it. So now is it the same or not? Here I have output group. First one is output group. Next one is new group. New group is input group. Got it? So now I am selecting all the columns here. Drag and drop. Here you see. The ports are located under output group. Ports are located under input group. So under output group, you have all the output ports. Under input group, you have all the input ports, right? Now simply double click on union transformation. Once go to the group ports, here you increase the size to 10. Here group, new group is there, right? Here I am giving EMP table 1. _ group. Second one, EMP file underscore group. I'm creating multiple groups, right?
Yeah.
EMP
table 2.
Table 2 underscore group. Group name you can give anything. But here group ports, here metadata you have to take care. If any adjustments you have to do like this, click on apply and OK. See, EMP table 1 group, that is the first input group, right?
Mm-hmm.
EMP file group, this is the second input group, right?
Yes.
So EMP table 2 group, this is the third input group. So from the sources, I connected to input groups in the union transformation. Understand? Are you clear?
Yeah.
Here, the union transformation is having output group. Output group gives you output data, right?
Yeah.
But here, if you see, in the target, I want a dimension key. So I'm creating one more transformation, that is
sequence generator.
Transformation, the name I am giving dim key gen. Okay. Click on create, click on done. Here is your sequence generator transformation. Okay. In this sequence generator transformation, I am giving start value 1, increment by 1, default end value, current value 1, right? Click on OK. Now drag and drop your target. What is your target? EMP all TBL, right? This is my target. So here from the sequence generator, next value to EMP dimension key, I connected. Got it? Yeah, this is the sequence generator transformation. This is the union transformation. From the union transformation, I'm connecting employee number to department number to target. Are you clear? You understand now? So here I merged data from multiple sources and generated a sequential key, dimension key, and loaded into the target. So this is how we can work with union transformation and also sequence generator transformation. Go to repository and save. All of you clear? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Just mapping is got saved. Then go to Workflow Manager. In the Workflow Manager, I need to create a session, right? Go to Task Developer, go to Tasks menu, click on Create. You create the session, STS underscore union underscore sequence generator, SCQGEN. Click on create. Here union sequence gen is the mapping name. Select the mapping. Click on OK. Click on done. So session is created. Double click on this session. Go to the mapping. Here source one is Oracle source. Oracle JSR DB. Good. Second one is flat file. Second source is flat file. So source file is located in Sushma folder. So take the source file directory is Sushma. Source file name is emp30data.txt. Then third source is again a relational database. Oracle JSR DB connection, connection object is specified. Then target. Target is SriniDB database connection. I selected SriniDB. Change the target load type to normal. Most of the people are forgetting this while practicing. Please keep in the mind.
Yeah.
So union transformation, sequence generator transformation. Click on apply and okay. Session is ready. Validate the session. Now go to the workflow. Create a workflow. Go to the workflows menu. Go to the workflows menu. Click on create. Create a new workflow, that is WF underscore union underscore SEQ gen sequence generator, right? Click on OK. Drag and drop the session. Go to the task, select the link task and connect them. Then go to the workflow, validate. Yes, it's good. Go to the repository, save it. Now open workflow monitor. Yeah, workflow monitor is opened. Now go to workflow manager again. Go to the workflows menu. Click on start workflow. Observe the execution status in the workflow monitor. It's running now. Yes. See here, from table 1, 5 records are extracted. From table 2, 9 records are extracted. From table 3, 6 records are extracted, right? 9 plus 11, 20. 20 records are loaded into the target. Now you go to target SriniDB. Just give the select statement, select star from EMP all TBL. See the data. So 1 to 20 serial numbers are generated or not? And employee records are inserted or not? Got it? Suppose if I execute this workflow again, understand? Same session, same workflow, I am executing again. So more 20 records will be loaded into the target. The serial number goes from 21. Got it? Now observe, right click, select the workflow and restart. Now again the workflow execution starts, right? Now see, the last value is 20. So it begins from 21. Understand, succeeded. Again 20 records are loaded. Now you run the query again. See, 21, 22 until 40, right? So like this, generated, dimension key will be generated. Now whether the data is duplicating or not, it doesn't mind, because employee number is not a primary key. Okay, so in no constraints are there, nothing is there, so it allows the duplication. But where duplication is eliminated, the serial number is eliminating the duplicate, right? So it is unique. This is unique identification number for every row. So like that, you can generate the dimension key even though the data is duplicated. Whenever in real time, if you are loading the dimension table, fact table, something like that, duplicates will come, because basically data warehouse allows redundancy. Data warehouse maintains historical data, so duplicate values will be there, right? So this dimension key is required. This is how to generate the numbers. This dimension key, numbers in a sequential order using sequence generator. This is how to merge the records from multiple sources together using union transformation. All of you clear about it? Are any confusion? So here, order transformation we done. And union transformation is also we done. Okay, it's fine. Now source expression transformation we done, aggregator we done, filter we done, joiner we done.
Yeah.
So tomorrow's class exclusively I cover source qualifier transformation. Understand? Tomorrow's class exclusively source qualifier transformation. Okay. By tomorrow morning, I will send you a video to all of you. Please watch it, which is for day after tomorrow's class. Once the source qualifier is completed, then I am going to discuss about a stored procedure transformation and lookup transformation. Okay. Stored procedure transformation is for stored procedure from the database. Lookup is very important transformation. So for the stored procedure transformation and lookup transformation, I will give you video, pre-recorded session. By tomorrow morning, you can find it in your mail. So please watch it. By the time I start discussing stored procedure and lookup, you must complete them. Okay? Yeah. Okay, fine. So tomorrow I'm going to discuss about source qualifier transformation. So using source qualifier transformation, how to use SQL override operation, how to perform the source level sorter, source level filter, source level merge join, source level expression, how to do that. We'll see within the source qualifier transformation. It is one of the very important transformation. By using a source qualifier transformation, you can perform SQL override. By SQL overriding, you can improve the performance. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and Rohit.
Yeah, yeah.
Rohit, by tomorrow morning, I will send you mail for all the links. Okay? If you miss anything, I will send you some pre-recorded videos also.
Oh, yeah, sure. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, all of you. Thank you. See you tomorrow.
Sir.
Yeah, Sushma.
Sir, now I have some doubts, sir.
Yeah, go
and
ahead.
And in SQL, not in Informatica.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, can you explain me about the 1 minute, sir. So, subqueries?
Query within the query. Nested query is what? Subquery.
Yeah. Actually, what I did was, in Google, I searched for some questions and then questions that the queries are now I am doing mistake in that.
So, do you want to aware about subqueries?
Yeah, just little briefing about that.
Brief and the good detail is this.
Sure.
Just a second. I'm giving you a link. Sushma,
I
will send you mail.
Okay,
okay,
sir.
Okay,
okay, fine.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Fine, all of you. Thank you. See you tomorrow. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.